Okay, I've got a Bakelite 3000 series phone. It's old retro type phone. I'm converting it to work on the latest type of plug. I think the model number is a 332. 332 hour, as you can see on there. And I've got a conversion kit off eBay from this guy. And basically it came with all the bits you needed, and now with the wiring diagram, and now I'm going to try to fit it to make my work for phone work. Okay, I'm going to pause it now and take it to pieces, come back to it. Okay, as you can see from the wiring diagram, I don't have a focus in on it, and there you go, and that's to where it is. So now I'm going to follow instructions and see what happens. Okay, come back in a sec. Okay, straight in with the problem. The problem is this wire, which I'm going to replace. Seemingly it says just disconnect the wires, but it's wedged in. I can't really get a better picture, but it's actually wedged in. Let's see if I can give you a bit of light on it. Oh, that's better. It's wedged in behind, so I might have to take the four screws out and just lift it to unwedge this wire so I can get access. I don't know what wires I've been damaging by yanking it, so I will come back to you and show you that. Okay, I've released the red and the green wire, but the actual cable, I don't know if you can physically see, but try to get a light in there. It'll be hard to see, but it's I think that's the best picture I can show you. It's actually tied around the actual screw support, not actually a wire, it's actually tied, so I'm just going to snip it and pull it out. Come back to that. Okay, I've snipped the wire, you can see it all snipped, like the tie which was strapped around, so now I can just basically remove the wires out the way. Might need 2 hands to do this. Oh, there you go. So basically just pulled it off. But the tie was actually tied around the cable to the support post. I presume that just locks it in. Is it? So they're removed. Okay, so now I have to do the slight alterations. And the alterations are remove strap T10 and T11. Look at cards. So T10 and T11 is this bottom strap here. So remove T10, remove T11, and remove strap T11 and T12. So those three links I've got to take out. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, I'm going to do that now. I'll come back to it and show you when I'm done. As you can see, I'm attempting to remove the strap, which is T10. Do you know what? I have to invest in a something to hold your camera when you're doing it. I'll remove those and show you when it's done. Okay, that link is removed from there. That link is removed from there. So those two links are removed as per instructions. That says insert the strap between T8 and T9. So I have to basically put the strap back on to T8 and T9. If you can see the instructions there. So there's T8 and T9 and T1 and 2 insert straps, but those have actually got the two straps pre-fitted, so I'll skip that part. Now I've got to insert a 3.3k ohm resistor between T11 and T12, and T11 and T12, 3.2 ohm resistor, and it's one of these. I've got to insert that between. So I'll do that now, I'll come back to it. Okay, I've put that resistor between. T11 and T12. Okay. Now I've got to put a rectifier 205 between T6 and T5, which are basically the headset two here. I'll do that now. Okay, that is put in place. I've tied up a bit with insulation tape just to make sure they're not going to touch when it's all put back together. But those pins are nice. Next step now is to collect the wires. I'll come back and show you that when I'm done. Okay, all done now. As you can see, the red wire is going to turn them all 9. The blue wires come to terminal 11. Green cord's gone to terminal 3. And the white is gone to terminal 1. The 205 has gone to T6 and T5. And the 3.3 ohm resistor has gone to T11, T12. And if you see from different angles that the resistors are not touching, they're sort of like free floating. So I don't think I'll bother putting any tape on them because they're not going to touch nothing, they're not going nowhere once the bottom's on. And the next test, the two clamps or ties or bridges or whatever you want to call them, I've actually screwed to this terminal here just to keep them in the phone, but they're not used just in case they're needed at a later date. And the wire tie which was supplied, I wire tied it down so the cable is nice and tight and can't pull out. It's a case of just basically putting them back together, plugging in and seeing if it works. Come back to that. Okay, upon first test I had a slight problem, so I had to literally strip the phone apart. Basically what was happening is the phone was actually receiving, so you had the dialing tone, but it would not break the dialing tone. So I stripped the phone down to pieces, and very hard to see in this light of mine. Turn it so you can get a better view of it. There's a connection on the side. There's the actual internal darling phone. There's the case as such. So it's coming across like so. Not a very good view. Clarity of picture. But as you can see, this bit here, when you put your phone down, it actually pushes this down. And when it pushes that down, it can't really. It actually breaks the contact at the back here, and one of these, that's a better view, you see it comes to breaks the contact, but the one on the right is not being broke, so it just wants a bit of fiddling just to break that bit of switch clean off, and try again. Okay, I think it's all sorted now, so that basically everything's tied up. I noticed one thing is that you have to, this plate here, if you're not careful, when you put screw it in from here to here, as it screws down, it can tilt slightly. And what happens is that it's tilted up on the back end, so the wires are higher, and the clicker wasn't breaking and making properly. So I have a little bit of little twinch and a bent on that piece I'd done before, but now it seems to be making and breaking. So now I'm going to sling it all together and give it a try, see what happens. Okay, just plugged it in. I'm going to try. Yep. Then I'm going to sing them out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a 1471. I'm going to press a 3, which will dial my last number. And that should. Phone me. Home phone number. Okay, so phoning out all right. Now, I'm going to phone my home number. Phone my home number and should. Work okay. And hello. Yep, got the echo coming. Lovely, lovely. So that's sorted. Bang on. Job's a good one. Not bad for a fiver.